sure we all spend time in prayer. But question always comes is when we read about prayer, ask and you shall receive, seek and you shall find. And then when we hear people keep telling us, keep asking, keep seeking, keep telling God what you need. Well, today I want to speak to you about the persistence, not for your personal needs, but persistence in prayer for intercession, praying for others. Persistence not for what you want, but persistence in prayer for the needs of others around you. You know, many a times we speak about asking, seeking and knocking for what you want God to do for you. Well, today I want to tell you, pray for the needs of others, intercede for others, seek God for what somebody else needs, the blessing that others are longing for. When you open to Luke chapter 11 verse 5, we see here it says, "And he said to them, which of you shall have a friend and go to him at midnight and say to him, friend, lend me three loaves. Friend, lend me three loaves." Now, if you read it till here, it looks like this friend or this man is asking those three loaves for himself. But read the next verse. He says, "For a friend of mine has come to me on his journey, and I have nothing to set before him." For a friend of mine has come. So this man is asking for those three loaves, not for himself, but for the friend that has visited him, for the friend that has come into his house. It's not speaking about his need. He's speaking about his friend's need. And then further he says, and he will answer him from within and say, "Do not trouble me. The door is now shut and my children are with me in bed. I cannot rise and give to you." Verse 8, "I say to you, though he will not rise and give to him because he is his friend, yet because of his persistence, he will rise and give him as many as he needs." Because of his persistence. But the persistence is for whose need? The persistence is for his friend's need. And that's what I want to tell you today. When you go before God in prayer, when you seek God, you know, put the needs of others before yours. Persistently pray for your friends around you. Persistently pray for those who are going through their own storms of life. I'm sure we all need our own, situations to be resolved. We all desperately want to rise up in life. We desperately want a job, our healing, our deliverance. But when you go before God, put the needs of others before yours. Be persistent in praying for the needs of your friends, for the needs of your neighbors, for the needs of your family. I tell you, as the scripture says, as you persistently pray for others, God will definitely hear that prayer. Not just that prayer, but he will also satisfy the desires of your heart. As you selflessly choose to bless others, God will willingly choose to bless you.